Greetings, Cauldron Weird, and we're back with some more K-pop 2020.
Yeah!
So cool, I have to say.
You do not need to fix your computers or phones. It is actually me. Corey is not here this time.
Corey has failed to show up once again.
Corey, you've gotten skinnier and somehow more soaked in alcohol.
Yeah, and more.
And not blind.
And drunker.
That too.
That's... And drunker. I'm always drunk.
Drunker.
Oh,
2020.
Then, yeah, there we go.
That's my New Year's resolution, to be more drunk.
Dateline 2020.
I've been succeeding for 31 days straight.
All right.
There we go.
How about that? Anyway, but, this is back by popular demand. More BTS.
Very heavily demanded, by the way.
Oh, yeah.
Very heavily demanded.
Like, as soon as the Black Swan video went up there, like, yeah, but what about James Corden? I knew we were going to get it.
It was funny.
That's why we didn't respond, because we knew we were going to do it.
Yeah.
It's just funny that the day you released that one was
the day that got released.
Yeah, it's like,
and yeah. I was like, I saw it as soon as it went up, and I was like, well, I guess we got to do that now.
I knew that was coming. So
anyway, we're going to do that.
Yes.
Black
right
Swan,
now.
James Corden. On it.
Do.
Debt.
Go.
Oh, well, now we know. Next month. First time on television. Please welcome
BTS. Oh, people going crazy.
As they always
do. That stage is so freaking tiny, dude.
It is.
Well, it's also in a studio, so.
Got the no shoes.
Ooh.
Yeah, dude. God, dude. See, now everyone's wearing black.
Yep.
As opposed to just having interpretive dancing. Yeah. It's a great song, too.
Yeah.
It's a really good song.
The gamer is thinking of Final Fantasy X right now. You know what scene.
Yeah. Yeah, and Makalani of Woods.
They are barefoot.
Yep.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying, dude. Yeah, yeah.
Man. Just another feather in that cap. This is when the water spirit appears.
That's what I love about BTS when they do these live shows. Just a lot of back and forth. They'll just kind of have two of them.
Play off each other.
And just play off it. I love it.
Oh, cool. Well, RM growing that hair out.
Yep.
See, they would not want me to have my shoes off if I was doing this.
Because
I would smell. I've got very hairy feet, too. So
like a hobbit.
Yeah.
They'd take you to the
waxer. Like, who let Frodo in here?
God. They'd take you to the waxer.
Destroy the smell of my studio. Yes.
You know, man.
Oh, man.
It's like 360 degrees of like colors and ambience and just all this stuff.
Yeah.
That was cool right there.
Man.
Yep.
Damn. Wow. Oh.
That will end it early.
Yeah.
Do I really don't care about James Corden. I
don't think anybody really does. They're just watching it for BTS.
That's it.
And look, he got his views.
Mm-hmm.
All right. Shut it down.
Shut it down.
Shut it down. Shut it down.
So I think we're all in agreement that James Corden is not funny. He's just fat.
Wow.
Fat shaming him right there. He can be as big as he wants.
No, he can't. It's unhealthy.
No, men can't be fat.
Yeah, they do it for comedy.
They do it for comedy.
That's his shtick.
But he's not funny.
It's like in the movie Cats, which we all saw, by the way.
No one saw.
And no one saw. So, it's not about James Corden. I think we can agree that...
Oh, yeah. Oh,
nice.
Now it's my fault. Who the hell is texting me? Okay.
Corey? Was it Corey?
Maybe. Anyways.
Tell him he's a failure. No, it's...
Oh, no, it's something for Bernie Sanders. Okay.
We're just kidding.
So, I think we're all in agreement that BTS is arguably, like, the best live performance group on the face of the planet.
Yeah.
Currently doing their job.
Yes.
Yep.
I think BTS are, we've said this many times before in a bunch of live shows, they have such a stage presence you can't even compare to.
You can't stop looking.
And what I think is so unique about them is what song that they're doing and how they can interpret with their choreography. We've seen choreography where they can be very sharp and kind of poignant with their moves. This was like, as silly as it sounds, it was almost kind of like a ballet.
Yeah.
Almost like that. Their moves. Like when they all kind of went together and they went real low to the ground and they kind of went around the studio right there. Mm-hmm. It's like, that's an interpretive dance move. That's what you'll see a lot in like ballets and stuff. So.
And that's why the other video did so well.
And it's very reflective of that.
They're reflective of what the... interpretive dance group did.
Yeah, so I have to applaud them for that. I mean, that's
all the way down to everybody being barefoot.
Yeah, it just had such a presence. It had such an impactful emotion to it right there. Here's the thing.
Do you think the interpretive dance group got to meet BTS?
Probably.
I would hope so.
I mean, I would think so. I would hope so. I mean, you're representing them, so I would hope you're gonna wanna.
They just call on the phone. Yeah, just do this thing for us, and then we'll put it up.
I'm sure it was a little more hand and shake. I think BTS, they are just masters of their craft. They have an impeccable, bar none, stage presence. They're very energetic. If they want to draw emotion, they can do those. And obviously they're doing the late night routes too. I mean, they've done Ellen and James Corden now. They've done Conan. Like, so they've done
Jimmy Fallon, right?
I don't think they did.
I don't know. We can check. We can check our sources.
Brian's gonna check right now.
So
he has done Jimmy Fallon.
He had him on when they were doing Idol.
Oh, that's right, a year ago. So I think they are unbelievable, and I think people just need to kind of grow to accept that they're just this wave of K-pop that's kind of really making an impact in the Western world.
Yeah, I remember.
So I have to give them a goddamn. If we're rating this here, I mean, I've got to give them a goddamn. They just
they know what they're doing.
There's nothing, and this is what is hard to do when we're reacting to BTS, because there's nothing really we can say that we haven't said before.
It's more just like, all right, what's the concept, and what am I going to see differently that I haven't seen before?
But I think this is different.
It is.
Each time that we see them, there's something new that they draw out.
The only thing that we can ever talk about is what's different than everything else.
Because yeah. I mean, I think for us, we're not professional choreographers, we're not professional singers.
We're not going to come to you and say,
I can dance around my way a shower. So,
dance your way in a shower.
Yeah.
Okay. Well, that's it's cold, and he's trying to stay warm.
I sound like Michael Jackson right there.
Yeah.
Careful, no, they'll come after you. HBO will be all over you.
We sound like we're repeating ourselves,
but I think truly to see their evolution, and they are evolving. I don't think any of us think that they're just kind of this stagnant group.
You notice they're getting to be in a more fluid kind of movement than they were with their sharp, edgy looks.
Yeah.
They're not doing edgy looks anymore. They're doing more fluid, more like your kind of martial arts kind of. Fluid motion, Bruce Lee kind of things.
Sure, I guess.
Especially
I guess
with that last one that we just saw.
And again, that's more reminiscent of the actual kind of more ballet style. It's supposed to be more fluid and more drawn out.
You're like, okay, people have seen us when we go hard, so let's show.
And they can still do that. They still have plenty of songs that they can do those things. I'm curious to see what they're going to bring new to the table. I don't think people are getting burned down on BTS. I don't think people they always can do something fresh. To see that they're starting to become more, kind of more into a spotlight for us here in the Western world, because it's obviously we've known about them, but then people are like, "Hey, he's in BTS." So, I think it's really cool. There's subtle things I'm a little bit of afraid
that they're gonna burn themselves out.
I think a little bit of that. I think they're gonna be a little burned out, and I think that people are very. I'm gonna say this in a very positive light, so please don't take it as a negative right there.
Okay.
Is that
even though you said it, someone will.
Probably. Is that I think that people that love BTS, the fans of BTS, I think they also need to understand that they are also people too.
Yeah.
And that when we put the pressure on them,
they're gonna feel it.
They are gonna feel it. It's
look at last year. How many K-pop stars did we lose?
I mean, I was just
at
reading
least three.
I was reading more people like. I mean, there's it's very very sad. It's very sad that you have these people in these groups, and you know they're making an impact on people's lives right there.
And people are like, oh, they don't read the comments, and I was like, well, no, they do.
We're a small group, and we read the comments. Imagine a group that's like,
let's put it more likely. They read the comments. I ignore them.
But I think with especially the fans is. There's nothing wrong with being passionate about a group.
You have to give that group their space.
But I think you need to be understanding that they might do... You're never going to agree with someone 100% of the time. Okay? There's plenty of groups that I absolutely love right there, and I go, well, I don't know. I don't understand why they maybe did some of these things.
And if you spend your entire life making sure that you agree with them 100%, you're not living your own life.
Yeah, and just take everything with an open mind. That's all we're saying, is that a lot... Okay, easy there. Is that
okay? Maybe not in this country, but the rest of the world.
That's what I'm saying. This is a completely different country, and so, you know, for them to kind of be out here in the United States, a lot of people aren't going to get it.
Yeah,
and that's their prerogative. I think for a lot of us is like, if you don't like it, that's fine. If you think it's too quote mainstream or it's too, you know, in the popular light right there and you don't like it, that's perfectly fine. We have that way with the Western world too, so, you know, whatever. Yeah. But just understand that maybe because they don't like it, it doesn't mean that it's a diss on culture, it's a diss on their kind of style. But that's the point I'm trying to make right here, because I was reading a bunch of stuff about them on James Corden and them on other shows, and then there's like a very strong emotion when they're on these shows and then fans of BTS kind of saying, well, they're doing it for the wrong reasons and stuff like that. You don't understand what these groups are really doing.
No.
Okay. It's like they have to promote themselves right there. So
this is how
if you think they need to be in a certain.
Plus they don't, I'm not saying they're owned, but they work for a record company.
They are essentially owned by a company.
Yeah.
You have a contract with that company, and you have to re-up every couple of years.
And that company's saying, you guys are going here.
In some instances, they might own your name. They might own your likeness.
Yeah.
So I could definitely
own your group name, for sure.
I could talk, and there's a plethora of examples I could pull up where people are very upset when someone makes a critical point on BTS or... what is that, Big Hit?
Yeah.
Against the company, and then people get very vocal, and there's a lot of backlash coming to it. It's like, you know, for us, we enjoy the music they put out. We enjoy their performances. They're very entertaining, and so that's why we enjoy them, that there's something fresh and different and new, and that's why we enjoy them.
We just don't want them to burn themselves out.
But we also take it that they're human beings.
Yeah.
They're human beings. They
have to take time off.
So
you have to decompress. You can't do this 365.
Wasn't it
days.
Something too like not Shawn Mendes, but whatever. There's like one of the guys who's been touring for like almost 36 months straight.
Who's
the dude from Ireland?
Right.
Super popular.
I don't know.
Whatever.
Doesn't matter.
Anyways,
Either way,
he's been touring for like three straight years.
He's got to be losing his mind.
Yeah.
And that's not...
That, Castle on the Hill.
You don't want
to
see...
You know what I'm talking about?
That happening to be...
Yeah, close. Yeah.
Whatever his name is.
Yeah.
Ugly looking dude. Ed Sheeran.
Ed Sheeran.
So like Ed Sheeran's been touring
that's
for like...
I was like...
Yeah. Oh, look, like it's like that red hair, ugly looking dude.
Yeah.
Like,
so Ed Sheeran, that dude from Ireland.
He's been touring for like almost like 3 straight years.
And maybe he likes that, but eventually he's
going to... Eventually he's going to want to do something, you know, else. kind of more to what he wants in his soul. So, you know, I think for us as fans, all we can do is like really enjoy him, support him as well as we can right here, but understand if they want to do
something else,
or if they need to take time, we need to respect that.
Yep.
And that's what I'll say about that.
God, what a tangent you went on.
That's true. We're at 17.
I've wanted to say it for a few videos because I saw it and it just... Because
you were reading the comments and now it's like, okay,
motherfuckers. No. It wasn't the comments. It was... I read videos. Other people's... watched other people's videos and other people's there, and it's like, I wanted to kind of say something for our opinion and, yeah, you know, how we feel as a group. It's our
don't
opinion.
Speak for me.
Shut up. You sit down and you be quiet.
You do not speak for
now
me.
Now drink. That's what I thought.
Coward.
Still, go home and play your Fortnites.
Yeah. Yeah, or whatever dumb game you're into these days on the
you know
on
what.
The pooter. Anyway, Bryant. I'll close it out.
I'm going to be very short. That was a goddamn for me.
Okay.
I love the performance.
Right.
I'm going to keep mine short because that was a web you had decided to weave, good sir.
Just for that, you get to do the outro.
Yeah, I guess.
Yeah.
Mine's goddamns. I still love that song, and that was an awesome live performance.
Video's a goddamn.
Yes.
Song's obviously a goddamn. Knew that beforehand going in.
Yeah.
We already heard it. Stage was a goddamn.
Yeah.
Very cool.
That was a cool
Probably
stage.
The coolest stage I've seen.
I was just waiting for like the Final Fantasy
you got
battle
the 3D
theme music
CGI
to go.
Going on and all that. With the lights.
Fucking super cool. Laser dinosaurs and everything, too, popping
out.
Hell yeah.
Stalling in the background. Laughing. Anyway.
Anywho.
Anyway. Yeah. Can't wait for the album.
It's going to be good.
It's going to be good. Can't wait for more videos. We know they're coming.
Yep.
Don't know when. Sometime between now and the 21st.
We could literally probably do another like 15 BTS videos because there's a lot of stuff being put out right now.
Yeah, and we probably will.
Sorry.
Bless you.
I react whenever we talk about BTS in a good way.
Why don't we go ahead and send us out, Chris?
So thank you everyone for liking, subscribing, watching to us. You know, make sure you ring the bell because we really like to have that little ding-a-ling. See? I'm making you regret me ever doing these right here.
Yep.
So please help support us by hitting the like button, hitting subscribe, ringing the bell. Check out our sponsors below, SeatGeek, SG Cauldron, all one word, $20 off your first purchase.
When you use the code, duh.
Or you can just get Honey. We need to do Honey as a sponsor so you can automatically get that put in there, right? Anyways. Yep. Save $20. What's Corey say? Save some of that government green.
Yeah.
Or whatever color that your currency is. You know, we don't judge. Another one we're going to do, Eargasm Earplugs.
Yep.
So link is going to be in the description right there. I think that's pretty much it, right?
Yep.
Yeah.
Yeah. Use Eargasm Earplugs, especially if you're going to go to a BTS show. Because you know it's going to be loud. There's going to be pyrotechnics. There's going to be all kinds of crazy stuff going on.
Explosions, dances.
Corey's at a Korn concert right now, and I guarantee he's got those suckers on there.
Oh, yeah. He put them in the second... He walked into the building.
Yeah, true.
The venue.
So it enhances his sight because he's blind.
It's true. They're so good. They help your sight.
And then, my God,
I didn't know he was Daredevil.
See
or is that
reverse
Daredevil?
It's reverse Daredevil.
See with your ears, the most boring Daredevil.
That's so dumb. You can check out our merch store. You can check out the podcast. Basically, wherever you get podcasts, I'll have that in the description as well. What else, man?
Twitches.
Yeah, Twitches. Yeah. Twitches Tyler. Twitch.tv/ragtimeroastbeef. Twitch.tv/MC_bootystank. I ain't got nothing on there because guess what? I ain't got no fucking time. So that's just how it goes. Yep. That's why we do everything on Ragtime Roast Beef right there.
Yep.
So hoping to do more of that. Starting up a D&D podcast, so check that out. So that's going to be, again, in the description where you get the podcasts. Then I think we should be good to go.
Yep.
Right?
And we'll see you in the next one, guys.
More BTS, please.
Bye.
Comment. Bye.
Bye.
Bye.